This is Jean. I just had a letter from my brother, and guess what? He's bringing his roommate home from college. Mother said we can have a party for him, so I was wondering if you could come over tonight and help me plan it. Yes, Nora's coming too. This is one party that just has to turn out right.
Well, the purpose of a party is to have fun together. And a successful party needs planning and skill. Whether it's a special carnival designed for gay entertainment, or a game party in a home, a birthday party, a holiday party, they all take planning, and they should all be fun. Now, the party Jean, Nora, and Eileen are planning, what of its purpose?
The main idea is to introduce Steve to the game. And show him a wonderful time.
Yeah, and show everyone a nice time.
Right. Now listen, this is what we have to plan. A guest list, invitations, refreshments, and entertainment. Now, a guest list. Who we ask? There'll be the three of us and our dates. And I suppose we could have an extra couple and two extra girls for Jim and Steve. Mm-hmm. Now, who do you think, Nora?
Well, let's have Alice and Ted come. They're nice, and they're usually in our gang.
Margie's lots of fun. The fellows would like her.
That's right, Eileen. And let's ask Dot. We certainly had a wonderful time at her party last month.
Oh, I'll say.
We all enjoy being together, but is anyone left out?
I don't think so.
Well, that's our guest list. Now, invitations. Should we write? Dear Alice, would you like to come to a party at my house Saturday, March 24th at 8 p.m. and so on?
Why bother to write? This is just an informal party. Let's just phone everyone.
Sure.
Good. We'll phone tomorrow. Next business, refreshments.
Yeah. We have to feed the men.
And the girls, too. Especially you.
Gee, thanks. Does it show?
Well, we want something to eat and something to drink.
Refreshments.
How about hot chocolate and sandwiches?
I'll fix the sandwiches.
Well, thanks, Eileen. Suppose I talk it over with Mother and get her suggestions.
Mm-hmm. All right.
All right, now next is entertainment.
We want to show Steve a good time, but, well, we don't know too much about what he likes. The best thing I know for breaking the ice and getting people acquainted is some good mixer games.
Oh, but they can be such a bore if you don't have good ones.
Well, let's go to the library and get some good magazines and books and find some really good games.
Oh, terrific.
I'll do that.
Oh, good. Then this party can just be an informal, get acquainted sort of party, and we'll have games for entertainment.
Yeah.
Well, there are still many details to be planned, but the basic things are settled. Guest list, invitations, refreshments, entertainment. All these things should be planned to fit together well. It's the big night. The planning and preparation will help make a good party. But what else makes a good party? It's the skill of the hosts and the skill of the guests in making the party fun for everyone.
Here we are, gang. Step right in.
Hi, Amy.
How are you?
Well,
I'm so glad you're here.
Finally made it.
Wonderful.
First, getting everyone acquainted and into the spirit of the party. How's it done?
Come in here, Steve. We'll wait here for the girls to put their coats away.
Okay, Jean.
Well, Steve, what do you think of our game? What you've met of them, I mean.
Oh, they're swell. But what's this about me being the guest of honor?
Oh, that's Jean's way of keeping you quiet.
Oh, I see.
Margie and Dottie were just thrilled to think you college men would call for them.
Oh, a couple of campus bigwigs we are.
You bet your life. Oh, I think our guests are arriving. Excuse me.
I hope you like our friend Steve.
Well, I hope they'll like me.
They will.
Hi, Eileen.
Good
terrific.
To see you.
Hello.
Hi.
Are we the first ones here?
Oh, no, Margie and Dottie are here.
Oh.
Hi, Jean. How you been?
Hello, Paul. I'm so glad you could come.
Well, you can't keep me away.
Eileen, this is Steve.
Hello, Steve.
Hello, Eileen. Aren't you the party planner I've heard so much about?
Well, and this is Paul Johnson, our star tackle.
Hi, Justine.
Glad to know you, Paul.
Let me take your coat.
Notice
Paul.
How Jean helps her guests get acquainted.
I'll go with you.
Oh, no, never.
Well,
mind.
The party is off to a good start. Guests are on time. Everyone's out to have fun and to help others fun. And when all the guests have arrived and have been introduced, the games begin. Well-planned, well-chosen games. First, a simple get-together game. Each one may ask questions and try to guess his own identity. This mixes the group well, and besides, it provides a means of choosing partners for the next game. Having fun together makes a party. This means both hosts and guests. Whenever any of the guests begin to lose interest in a game, the host should start a new game, so fun together can continue. And, of course, the guests have a part in this, too. Each one should try to make the games fun. Each should take part in what the group is doing. And if some guests forget this, well, anyone, even another guest, can help get the entire group together again.
Nora, Jim started that hat-making contest that you like so much. Come on.
Take care of her. I'm going to make a hat for her. And in the end, we're going to give the prize to the best hat. All right, now here are your materials.
A hat-making contest? Well, this will reveal some talent. The party is going well again. Have you noticed some of the skills of the guests that help keep the party fun for all? Let's look for others. And did you ever play rhythm?
1-4.
I can sing. I'm great
again.
1-3.
3-2.
2-7.
7-2. Oh, no. You broke out of turn.
Yeah, you're out. You're out, too, because you did that.
I was 6.
But you didn't know, as long as you got
1-7.
Or how about charades?
Second.
I know. Turn going out.
And then, at just the right moment...
Is anybody hungry? Everything's ready.
Is anybody hungry? Well, a little snack certainly is pleasant about this time of evening. Simple food, buffet style, an informal way to serve refreshments. Each one can serve himself and help the others, too. And while everyone finishes eating, a little more spontaneous, unplanned fun.
Oh, do you play, Steve?
Does he play? Show him, Steve.
Oh. Come on in,
master and him display, and pass the bottle when he got dry. And
brush away bluegill pie, Jimmy crack corn and I don't care, Jimmy crack corn and I don't care, Jimmy crack corn and I don't care. The master is gone away.
And part of a good party is knowing when to go home. Soon after refreshments have been served. Now, let's think back. What made this party such a good one? What do we want to do next time? If you are going to give a party, plan that party around a purpose. Choose your guests carefully. Plan invitations, plan for refreshments and entertainment. Then, practice to be a skillful host. Make sure the party is fun for everyone. And when you're invited to a party, practice the skills of a good guest. Be on time, ready for fun. Take part in the party. Help everyone around you to have a good time. Leave on time and courteously too, thanking your host sincerely for the good time you've had. All these things help to make a good party. A party that's fun for all.